I'm Andrew Leibarger. I'm going to be working on limited relevant electronics, specifically test bed for space-worthy motion control. Space robotics are kind of inherently remote and necessitate a really high level of reliability. During the design process, there's some tools, mechanical simulations, and information like mean time between failures that can be used to design higher reliability, but to really verify, you need to do testing. Some testing's in a lab and some's in the field. This will focus on lab testing. To make sure that the testing is accurate, you need the equipment you're working on to be as close to the flight hardware as possible. So this project is going to be working with this brushless motor controller from International Rectifier. There's been some previous work done on it by Nick Letwin, but one of them burned up, so there's a concern about longevity and how applicable it is. So one of the first tasks is going to be to contact the manufacturer, make sure that we are appropriately interpreting the data sheet, and that we are building the circuit correctly. Nick designed and built this circuit, which allows you to control the motor manually with a potentiometer. The goal by midterm is to augment that design so that it can be driven from a computer in an automated sense. There will be some sort of interface circuitry. You notice I use the very generic word of computer. You need whatever computer is applicable by midterm. The goal by end of term is to upgrade that to something that is reasonably equivalent to our current testing system. My understanding is right now that's the robot operating system. The goal is also to provide feedback from the controller. The controller can provide speed and power consumption data. It doesn't have a built-in feature for position, but there are Hall effect sensors that should be able to be incorporated. And the goal is to build this into a test bed to specifically test this motor controller, but then also have the capacity to test specific motors and then control software.
How do you cool this? Typically on Earth it's convection fans, and one of the reasons that we burn chips up is by not cooling.
I would expect for bench testing to start with a kind of standard heat sink and fan, like found with power electronics or CPU.
Burning it up aside, have you pondered the old move of freezing that module to cryogenic?
Not yet.
And life comes at you point blank, so I'll ask you again. Well, maybe in another way. Would you freeze it to cryogenic temperature after you get it going?
Yes.
Great. Great move. Others?
Are you going to take a look at the old IC and try to figure out why it failed?
Yes. As well as the old boards that I can hold.
That's great. And it's another one where that company might help you out. Mm-hmm. Very Christopher.